I add subtitles to every single one of my YouTube videos. I used to use rev.com, but a lot of my videos are over 10 minutes long, some over 30 minutes long, so it was starting to get expensive. For the past year, I've been using Descript for my YouTube subtitles, and when you're on the creator plan, which is $12 a month when billed annually, you get up to 10 hours of transcription per month. Here's how I do it. After I'm finished editing my YouTube video and I've exported the video file, I open up Descript and then I click on New Project. And then we're going to create a new project and it's going to open up a new Descript file. Now from here, I just drag in the finished video file right here into the left column. So this video file is 28 minutes long. It took about 20 seconds for it to get added. And now Descript is transcribing the audio. When it starts transcribing, it'll pop up this menu that'll say that you can distinguish between the speaker names. It's usually just me, so I don't ever add anything. And then you can see here, it'll show you the progress as it's transcribing the audio. So that took about a minute to transcribe a 28 minute video file. So here on the left, you'll see the transcription. And then on the right is the corresponding part of that video. When it does the transcription, the text is already like synced to the audio, right? So if I go down here, it's already skipping to that part of the video. So I'm always surprisingly impressed with the way that Descript does its transcription in terms of accuracy. It's always surprisingly pretty good, but there are always things that I have to correct. So for example, in this video, I'm talking about my cholesterol levels. I'm saying my total cholesterol was at 209 and it spaced it out. That's not a big deal. You could probably just leave that, but I like to have everything a certain way. So to correct your subtitles, to correct the transcription file, what you want to do is highlight over the part that you want to correct, and then you can click on correct, or you can push C for correct on your keyboard. So I'm going to push C and it's going to open up the correct window, and then I'm going to type in the correction right there and then hit correct. So the reason why you want to do it this way and not just start typing in here is because even though this looks like a Word doc, right, it looks like you could just kind of, you know, I could just like take do this and then like backspace this. What you're actually doing is editing the video file, because Descript is also a video editor. This is a really cool way to edit, but that is a story for another video. So we're just going to be talking about captions right now. And if you want to change the captions without editing the video, that's when you have to push C for correct, right? So here's LDL. It's all spaced out weird. Again, you can push C or hit correct right here. And I'm going to type in the correction. So typically what I do is I just start reading it. I read a lot faster than the video actually goes. So I read. One thing that I do want to show you is a very handy tool, which is the find and replace. So one of the things I talk about in this video is a company called Thistle, which is spelled thistle like the plant. But there are a few times where Descript thinks I'm saying this soul. Right? So instead of manually correcting it every time I see it, I could use the find and replace button. So I can just click this magnifier glass right here to open up the search box, or you can hit Apple F, and then I'm going to type in this soul. And here on the right, it'll show you the search results of every time this soul has popped up in the transcription. And then you can see, you can verify like if this correction is correct, right? With the context, you could just like click and see like, okay, I want to correct these. So what I'm going to do is type in the correction, the actual correction here, and then you can select which search result to apply that correction to, or just apply it to all. So this, I can say it should be applied to all. So I'm going to click on this and boom. Now, instead of this soul, it actually says thistle. I use the finder in place all the time, especially for my videos on my video game channel, because there's funky character names and names of places that are, you know, they're just made up names. So I have to spell the correction correctly and it pops up multiple times throughout the transcription. And it just, it saves so much time to be able to do that. So when I've gone through the entire transcription and corrected it, I am ready to export. So what I'm going to do is hit the publish button up here, and then I'm going to go to the export menu and then click on subtitles. By default, Descript is going to export this subtitle file as an SRT file, which is the file that you want to upload to YouTube. So then I'm going to click export and save that to my desktop. And now I'm going to head on over to YouTube. So I've already uploaded this video. And usually what I do is I upload videos as private, and then once the video is processed, that's when you can go in and like add your end screens and your cards and your subtitles and stuff like that. So I'll go to the subtitle menu here. Usually when I get to this menu, the file that is here is YouTube's auto-generated captions. So I'll usually delete those and I'll add a new language. So I'm just gonna add like another English just to show you an example. And then you can click the add button right here. And I'm gonna click on upload file. You're definitely gonna wanna select with timing, and then that's gonna prompt you to upload an SRT file. Here it is, click open, and it'll upload to YouTube, and you'll be able to see that all the timings should be there. If for some reason you need to, you know, refine and edit more, you can do that here, but usually I finish all of that in Descript, and then you can hit publish right here. Now, if you haven't given Descript a try, check out the link in the description. You can start off with their free plan, which comes with 1 hour of transcription per month. Hope that was helpful. Catch you in the next one. Bye.